Hello, Cloud Gurus. My name is Broadus Palmer, and I want to welcome you to GCP This Month for June 2020. GCP continues to deliver some great features and functional updates to make the platform even more enjoyable to work with. Today, we'll go over some updates to cloud identity and access management, some great new networking features. We'll dig into some additions to GCP Video Intelligence API, plus many more important updates. Just a reminder that we have less than 1 month left before the start of Google Cloud Next OnAir 2020. Now, if you haven't registered yet, be sure to take advantage of the 9-week run of brilliant content that really has some great speakers. Now, check out the link provided in this month's episode for more information and to reserve your seat. Now, let's get started. Google's Bring Your Own IP service is now available for Compute Engine in beta. Bring Your Own IP allows companies to bring their own public IP fixes while letting Google Cloud handle the routing announcement for you. Availability of the service is subject to approval from Google, and applicants must be wanting to bring blocks of 256 addresses or more to be considered. Now, Google's documentation on this is still a little light, so stay tuned for further details in the future. External load balancer header and parameter-based routing has finally entered GA. No longer do you need extra services like Nginx to manage your routing for custom situations. External load balancer can now natively make decisions based on HTTP header information and URL query parameters. A/B testing, selector routing to different backends, or just giving different user experience based on URL parameters just got a whole lot easier. Transaction statistic tables, a new feature for Cloud Spanner, which helps investigate performance issues, is now in general availability. This feature can help you discover potential bottlenecks that are impacting latency in your database. The new dynamic SQL feature for BigQuery is now in beta. Using Execute Immediate, it will allow you to execute dynamically generated SQL streams from within BigQuery. Now, for those who aren't aware what dynamic SQL can do, it allows for client applications to act interactively, passing different information at different times from the user. Now, this will mean more custom and dynamic experiences for the user and less guesswork for software designers. There's been a definite push for ML and AI development at Google over the past few years, and their efforts show no sign of slowing down, with GCP announcing some cool updates for their already impressive services. Now, Google Cloud Intelligence API is now even smarter, with person and face detection available in beta. Now, these features can now detect the presence of a person or look for faces in a video, and is able to carry that context over and identify them across multiple videos and video segments. These additional features allow for attributes like clothing and hair, as well as poses, through recognition and tracking for up to 17 different body landmarks. This means we could potentially identify a person's mannerisms with the combination of pattern matching. Now, that's some pretty powerful stuff. Another great development that the Google team has released is real-time audio translation, now in beta. Now, this technology allows for impressive low latency translations on live streaming audio or from pre-recorded audio files. Now, currently, Google API supports 11 source and target languages, with more to come. So that's it for this month's Bytes. Let's get into our GCP Gems. Now, for our first gem this month, we're going to take a closer look at Cloud Functions, which is getting a pretty cool upgrade with the recent announcement of Java 11 support in beta. Now, prepare yourselves, my fellow developers. This means that you can finally create Cloud Functions using all of your favorite JVM languages, Java, Groovy, Scalar, Kotlin, and more, complete with access to whatever required resources your functions need within your private VPC. Now, this is a huge win for serverless application backends, giving developers more freedom and the power to create seamless integration with third-party backend services and APIs. Now, this also provides the possibility to integrate with mobile or IoT backends, as well as the ability to process data in real time. Now, you can write HTTP functions that dynamically respond to HTTP events and create backend functions to process triggers and events from many GCP services like File Store, which has also recently had its own scalability upgrade, PubSub, Cloud Storage, and more. Now, this will provide a seamless interlink between applications' front and backend services thanks to functions now supporting Java 11. Are you like me, tired of constantly having to jump in G Suite and manage users and access management permissions? Well, it sounds like Google has finally heard our demands and asking for these features for so long. Cloud Identity and Access Management has released in beta the ability to create and edit Google Groups within the Google Cloud Console. Google Groups allows you to manage users at scale, as each member of the Google group inherits a Cloud IAM role granted to that group. Now, this allows you to use the group's membership to manage all the users' roles instead of requiring you to grant Cloud IAM roles to individual users itself. Gone are the days of having two browsers open for managing groups and privileges. No more jumping between different interfaces anymore. We can simply manage groups and permissions from within the Cloud Console. You'll be able to view, create, and delete groups. And if data sharing is enabled for your organization, you'll be able to view the automatically generated audit logs for any time someone changes your group's membership, all in one place. This new update is the beginning to bring the administration experience of GCP to the sweet spot where everything can be managed centrally. A one-stop administration spot, if you will. Our winner for this month's GCP Guru of the Month is Eric Post. Eric is a lead cloud security engineer from Virginia. Congratulations, Eric. We'll be sending you a care package containing a t-shirt, some stickers, and a hand-signed card. For all you other gurus who want a special prize package, try your luck by answering questions which can be found in the provided link. Now that's all we have for this month's Google Cloud Platform release. Tune into next month's video for more great announcements. I'm Broadus Palmer, and thanks for joining me on GCP This Month.